Hello, this is a programme from the BBC Learning English Archive. It was first broadcast in August 2006 on the BBC Learning English website. We hope you enjoy it.
BBC
LearningEnglish.com.
Hello, I'm Anna Jones and this is London Life. And in today's programme, we're looking at a very English custom. What do you think this woman is describing?
I think the whole art of tea taking is a very elegant and very English thing to do. This whole ambiance of tea taking makes you be elegant.
Well, that was Jerry Pitt, who's the Director of Press and Public Relations at the Ritz Hotel in central London. And she's describing the very English custom of having tea or tea taking. The Ritz Hotel is one of the most famous hotels in London, and this year is celebrating its centenary. It opened 100 years ago in 1906. Its centenary. The Ritz is especially well known for its wonderful teas, but taking tea at the Ritz is not an everyday event. It's a special occasion and usually reserved for a birthday or an anniversary. Tea is served in the beautiful surroundings of the Palm Court. Displays of flowers and palms add to the experience of tea-taking. Jerry says that the whole ambiance of tea-taking, the whole character or quality of the Ritz, makes you feel elegant, it makes you feel attractive, and you behave in a very graceful way. And it's not just a cup of tea either, it's almost like having a three-course meal. Listen to Jerry as she describes the food served with a pot of tea. What do you eat with tea at the Ritz?
Actual food items on the tea menu come on a three-tiered cake stand, the bottom being the finger sandwiches, very traditional, and the waiter will explain what the fillings are. And then we do our scones in the middle, and we do our cakes and pastries on the top. And, you know, it's done almost like courses.
Well, we hear that the food arrives on a three-tiered cake stand. There are three levels, one on top of each other, and on each level there's a plate for holding the food. And what food is there? Well, Jerry tells us that there are finger sandwiches. These are small sandwiches filled with a variety of different things. And she describes this kind of sandwich as very traditional. If something is described as traditional, then it's been going on in the same way for a very long time. So finger sandwiches have been part of the traditional English afternoon tea for a long time. In the middle of the tier, there are scones, which are small round cakes, which are often eaten with jam and cream, which is known as a cream tea. And finally, at the top of the tier, there are various cakes and sweet pastries. Jerry says that tea is almost done like courses, a part of a meal which is served separately from the other parts of it.
BBC Learning English.
Now, what about making the tea? How do you make a proper cup of English tea? What does Jerry say is the most important thing about making a cup of tea? Have a listen.
The crucial things about tea making and tea taking is that the water should always be absolutely piping hot, and it has to be on the boil and boiling, and then you let the leaves stew. And we don't put milk in first, simply because we feel that it's up to the guest to decide how strong or weak they would like their tea.
According to Jerry, the most crucial thing about tea making, the most important thing, is to make sure that the water is piping hot. It's very hot and has just boiled. Then, after pouring the water onto the tea leaves, you let the leaves stew or absorb the water to make the tea. If you hear someone talking about stewed tea, they're describing tea that's been left too long in the teapot before being poured, and it tastes strong and bitter. What about the milk? What is the tea making etiquette? What are the rules or socially accepted way of adding the milk? Does it go into the cup before the tea is poured or afterwards? Well, at the Ritz, the etiquette or the accepted way is to add the milk afterwards, so that the guests can decide how strong or weak they would like their tea. Well, as we mentioned earlier, the Ritz is a very famous London hotel. So famous, in fact, that its name now appears in the dictionary as an adjective. What do you think it means? Here's Jerry.
Even the name, the Ritz, has become now generic in the dictionary. The Ritz, people talk about things being ritzy, and, you know, even if it's, you know, something's not very ritzy or something is very ritzy, and that all comes from the name.
Well, if something is described as ritzy, it's expensive and fashionable. It's a bit like the Ritz Hotel. So you might describe somebody's dress or car as ritzy. Well, it's 4 o'clock now, so it must be time for a cup of tea. That's all from London Life.
BBC.
LearningEnglish.com.